Well, different people have different ideas about the relationship between research and evaluation. I like to think of them as using the same tools for different purposes. Both research and evaluation are methods of systematic inquiries. The difference really lies in the purpose. The primary purpose of research is to create generalizable knowledge about the way that the world works, or to contribute to that knowledge. And the purpose of evaluation is to provide you with immediately useful information about a specific program or policy in a specific context. Evaluation really has a more short-term goal, which is to immediately give you information that you need to make decisions. Both research and evaluation are integral, to my mind, to the process of trying to improve population health and trying to do so in a way that incorporates all the multiple factors that we know affect health. We want our actions to be informed to the extent possible and the best possible understanding of how the world works. I think it's particularly important that we try not just to look at the symptoms of a problem, you know, high rates of uncontrolled diabetes, for example, but to try to understand what are the root causes of those problems. Research and evaluations of other interventions that have been tried in other contexts can help us think through the possible solutions. And then, of course, evaluation, including ongoing monitoring of how well you're doing, is going to be essential once you start implementing your own solutions. One of the challenges that population health improvement projects face is getting the capacity that they need to do the research and evaluation work that's really going to support their efforts. Many public health departments do have some capacity in this area, but other smaller health departments will not. Universities will often be able to provide this kind of support. One of the things that I think teams that are engaging in population health improvement should consider is, over the long term, whether they want to build their own capacity to do research and evaluation. I think, to the extent that, especially for simpler kinds of evaluation work, that groups can acquire that own their own capacity to do that, the better, because then they can save external resources for more complicated kinds of evaluation work. So the playbook provides a lot more detail on some of the issues that I've been talking about. There are a number of sections that deal with thinking about data, how to understand data, and more general sections on monitoring and evaluation. The playbook also provides you with information about a variety of different kinds of data sources that are available for doing this kind of work, and tells you about some of the strengths and weaknesses of those. At one level, I want to say research and evaluation work is simple. It's basically asking a question, figuring out what information you're going to need to answer that question, and then going about collecting and analyzing that information in a very straightforward way. At the same time, when you have spent a lot of time doing this work, there are things that you understand about potential snafus along the way. One of the big things is recognizing that data collection is not necessarily a simple task, and that you really need to collaborate from the beginning with everybody involved to think about what data elements you're going to need and how you can get that data without creating too much burden for the people implementing the program, the beneficiaries of the program, and so forth. The key, as it is for so many things in population health improvement, is really engaging with your partners from the start. So that's one consideration. The other is recognizing that data are not always what you think they are. That a lot of times you'll be working with data that were collected potentially in an inconsistent way. Finally, I think a key consideration is recognizing that there are multiple ways to interpret your findings. And so this is another place where it's very important to bring your partners together who will all have different perspectives on what these findings mean. If you didn't get the outcomes you wanted, why was that? Was it that the theory behind the program didn't really work, or was it that there were problems with implementing the program? So you need to have people at the table who kind of know the backstory and who can help you interpret what you find. The playbook goes into the issues around creating metrics to measure your performance, and with particular attention to metrics that are going to be of interest in health improvement efforts. And it also has links to a number of resources and tools that can really help you in your research and evaluation efforts. In addition, it tells you how to reach out and make contact with the partners who might help you improve your research and evaluation capacity.